Well, welcome everybody to Mount Van Hovenberg for the biathlon here at the Lake Placid 2023 FISU World University Games. Now, today we are here for the single mixed relay competition. Women go first. They'll do two loops, shooting twice. Then they'll hand over to their teammate. The male skier will do two loops, shoot twice, and then they'll do that over again. So basically four legs. If you leave the range where the target is not complete, then you will do a penalty loop. Two team members on each team. We've got 12 teams in the competition, and the women will ski a total of 6 kilometers and the men 7.5. So this is the start list. Czech Republic looking good. France, Poland, Norway. They are top seeds, but don't count out Ukraine. It could pull a surprise. The air temperature has warmed up today. The overcast weather has increased the humidity, but it's also a bit of a thermal blanket. And yesterday was around about -7. Today, -1.
Ready?
They're off, and we have a clean start. So this will be a fast and furious contest, and a lot of it is down to the shoot. So they go out of the stadium, up the small hill. You can see the coaches running alongside with spare poles. No one had any issues in the start. It can get quite tasty when you've got lots of skiers all really close to each other. But leading us out is the team from the Czech Republic. Teresa Jandová. Now there is a benefit from sitting in the slipstream on these descents. And that's why the shooting is so important. The speed of the shooting and of course the accuracy. Bit of a split developing. As they come up to the first intermediate time, the very initial 0.9 of a kilometer, and we can see that it is Russo that has moved up the field and has overtaken Jandová. Poland in third, with Anna Nedza Kurabinicek. So at that first split, we've got Canada, Czech, Poland. Oh, and Kazakhstan? Yeah, is it Kazakhstan? Yeah, Kazakhstan. Krykukova. So we're coming into the range for the first time. Opening up ever so slightly, but remember, 10 seconds on the shooting range is nothing. It feels like a lot, especially after watching the cross. And Sharla Russo from Canada establishing a lead. And we thought this would be the case. She was the gold medalist in the women's competition. Can she shoot as well as she did a couple of days ago? So now when they come into their range, it's not like in the 12K competition where they can choose which position to shoot from. They go in their numbered position. The first shot is prone. And Russo's missed one already. So a miss for Canada, two misses for Canada. Miss for Kazakhstan. Oh, look at this. Yandava is shooting brilliantly. So Yandava in and clean. And five misses for Russo. Now, the difference is, and you can see this with the French biathlete there, Pauline Matchett. If you miss, you can reload. You have three chances of reloading, and you can see Matchett reloading individually. You only have three chances to do that. So if Matchett can hit the second bottom of the targets, then she will go clear and not have to ski a penalty loop. So the difference in this competition is that you have the option to reload with three spare cartridges. So you effectively have eight shots in order to get down the five targets. If you leave the range and there's still a target that hasn't gone down, then you will have to ski a penalty loop. Well, the Czechs were the favorite going into this, but it can all change around on the range, as we saw with Shiloh Russo. Kukkonletto from Finland in second. Nedza Kubinicek of Poland is in third. And the American, Chersey Boulay, in fourth there. Kazakhstan, Ariane Krikova in ninth. Ukraine, Yulia Horonda she's in sixth place. Matchett, France in seventh. Sasaki, eighth. Dengarud, ninth. Russo down in 10th place. So second time into the range for Teresa Yandava. This time it's standing. Two sets of targets on top of each other, one set up for the prone, one set up for the standing. The standing target is about the size of a CD, prone target about the size of a golf ball. And look at that shooting from Teresa Yandava. Absolutely flawless. And it wasn't just that it was completely accurate, it was fast as well. The shooting time was very, very good. That's the finish. Hilda Kukkonletto, and she's having to reload. This pesky last target is not going down for her. Gets it finally. I'm seeing the split from Yandava, but that is Anna Nezda Kubinicek. So at the exchange one, Czech Republic were 42 seconds ahead of Finland. Ukraine 2 seconds behind, then Kazakhstan, then Poland, then France, Norway, Canada, Japan, United States, and Slovakia. The Australians haven't made the exchange yet. So very quickly, Jakub Kojcan has gone around that first lap. And Kojcan comes in. The last split at 3.9 kilometers, he had a 41-second lead over Mukin of Kazakhstan. Then from the Ukraine, it's Stefan Kinash. So the third shoot, what can Jakub Kocian do? First is prone. So one miss from Kocian, so one chance to reload. Missed the first. So going back to it and gets it. So just a little bit of time lost with the reload, but Kocian will maintain the lead. Now it was about 41 seconds going in. As we're watching Alexander Mukin from Kazakhstan, number 9. And you can see he has missed. He's missed 4. So reloading, you can see number 9, Alexander Mukin. So the last time that she will face this big climb, won't want to go too far into the red going up the hill though, needs to go into the range, and if she can shoot cleanly then she will have done her job for the Czech Republic. Lovely fluid technique on the climb, looking very relaxed. And Yandova looking very good. 23 minutes into this race. She'll be handing over very shortly to her teammate Jakub Kocian. There is the pole, Anna Nezda Kubinacek, followed by Ukraine, Yulia Horonda. So we said at the beginning that Ukraine could be the dark horse in this contest, and it's proved to be just the case. They're lying in bronze medal position, but the gold is looking very comfortable for Czech Republic now. As you can see the time difference, it's a whole minute. And if Jandová can avoid a complete disaster at the range, then will give her teammate Jakub Kocian a real chance to go on and ski for gold. So here is the leader, Tereza Jandová. Final visit to the range for her. Oh, a miss. Well, she's been so good that that pesky last one. The advantage that she's got, she can take that And let's go and see if we can see the exchange from Teresa Yandova. There it is. Jakub Koitsan waits on, and Yandova gives absolutely everything. She's done her job.
Pushed this man off the podium in day one, and now he is in control for the gold medal. He's got 3.15.
Jakub Koitsan, well, he was fourth in the 15K competition. Teresa Yandova took the bronze in the individual, so this could well be her second medal. As we watch the pole, Anna Nezda Kubinacek. And she has had a bit of a problem there. Missed four. Had to reload once. I think that means she's doing a penalty loop. No, hold on, no, she's only missed one. She only had to reload once. So Koitsan, well ahead. And he'll come up to this 11.4 kilometer split. So we've got silver and potentially bronze, which will be a real close battle. And then climb the hill, go down the hill, and it will all come down to that eighth chute. So Koitsan coming in for his final chute from the standing position. So he goes in to the range in the lead, a good minute ahead. He looks pretty comfortable. He's just, he knows that it all comes down to this. He's got the time. He can take the time. So he loads the magazine. Getting the breathing done. And then settles in, keeps the shoulders steady, breathing through the stomach moving, the shoulders staying steady. Three targets are down, four, five, and he's clear. And he knows he's done it. There was a bit of a wry smile there. He knows he's got the gold. For the Czech Republic, Jakub Koitsan and Teresa Yandova are going to take gold. Well, those biathletes are being lapped. They're still in the prone position. This is the next one coming in. 59 seconds back is Kinash as he comes into the chute. And Garnier is 105 seconds back. So this is the battle for the silver medal. Who will take silver? Who will take bronze? It's going to come probably from these two. But if they rush it and go for it too quickly, then they could open the door up to Kazakhstan, who've just entered the range now. Alexandra Mukin. And a miss for Ukraine. A miss, two misses for Ukraine. One miss for France. Garnier, if he can shoot this one clear and then go back, he's reloaded. Ukraine have got it. Garnier's got it. It's going to be really close. It is going to be really close, that battle for silver or bronze. So we're going to have to watch this one really closely. We've got Ukraine against France for the silver medal. The gold medal is almost, well, is 100% going to go to the Czech Republic. And you can see how Jakub Kocsár knows that he can afford to take it a little bit easy, just get some breath in before he will then go hard up this hill for the final time. Cheers for Ukraine, for Stefan Kinash. But look at Axel Garnier coming in hard from behind. We're going to have to see the gold cross the line clearly, but we also want to see the battle that's going on behind. Good minute ahead. Looks to me like Ukraine have got some distance. There's a little bit of daylight. The camera does foreshorten it slightly. Oh, I don't know, it's like 3 or 4 seconds. 3 or 4 seconds. It's all down to this final hill for the silver or bronze medal. What can Axel Garnier do? Can he catch the athlete from Ukraine? They're going for it. Hammer and tongs. Kocsár can't be far away from the finish, but look at this battle for silver. And it is the Frenchman that's going to do it. That was the move that will give the silver medal to France. We're going to see the gold medal decided. And it looks like it's going to be France and silver. But Czech Republic take the gold. Teresa Jandová congratulates Jakub Kocsár. And to be fair, they both were excellent today. So look at Garnier. The Frenchman made the move on the final hill and flew past Stefan Kinash from Ukraine. So it's going to be France. And Axel Garnier bronze in the 15K. Oh, just catches it right on the finish line. But silver for France and bronze for Ukraine. And there are our gold medalists in this mixed relay competition. What a race. Czech Republic in the gold medal position. France in second. Ukraine in third. Great for Ukraine.
Teresa Jandová and
so congratulations to our medalists, and it was an exciting competition, but I think the Czechs today were just too good.